20th episode, you're thinking we'll record live at someone's rooftop with an audience or something.
We thought by the 20th episode we'll have fans. I mean, we've been thinking about doing a podcast for a long time.
Yeah.
And then we got the name Yuck.
So we're like, time to do a podcast.
I think we just recorded one when we were like just high or something. And then we figured out, we sat on the edit and we figured out, okay, our style of doing reels is interesting. No one was editing podcast reels like that.
Okay.
So our hope still is that one of our reels or shorts makes it, and then everything else is a trickle down effect.
Wow.
So the hope in your face.
And
you're
like articulating your strategy.
Why did you make me say it, man?
Sorry, dude. I was like,
kya plan kya bhagwan?
And then every Tuesday I keep a fast.
This is I don't know, I think it'll work. Let's be optimistic.
Have you been on any other podcasts?
A long time ago. I used to do radio, dude.
Oh, damn.
Before comedy.
You have a radio career as well.
Yeah, but not that hacky, that kind of radio.
Good morning, Mumbai.
But how did they allow you to be just normal?
Dude, I think I slipped through the cracks or something. Because like on prime time, that's when most of the ad revenue is. So then you have to do that hacky radio show. But if you're doing it some weird hour, then nobody like really cares that much also. So you can say whatever you want. Me and a friend used to do it. And then they don't listen only, I think.
What time was this?
It was like weekends at like 11 a.m. to noon or something.
Oh, wow.
So nobody's really driving that time.
Yeah.
So nobody, not high stakes. But then one day they'll be like, dude, you can't just say anything on radio. Can't be talking about cocaine. Like, calm down.
Sorry, exactly, sorry.
Yeah. It's fun.
What's up? Say hi to the camera. Yeah, that's the only. Oh, you thought we have a multi camera setup.
Why is he charging his toothbrush in the hall?
Dude, maybe
it's
just.
No, we just.
Cut around, you cut around, right?
Just like jump cuts and
yeah.
Scale in.
Nice. I went to the Den last week, I was in Bombay.
Oh, dude, that's still open. Or what?
Yeah.
I thought after lockdown, that used to be the shit when there was Zomato Gold. Remember? We all used to go fucking 1+1 on drinks.
Oh.
Hey, we saw Poonam Pandey there, dude. With
at
her,
the Den?
With her boyfriend, Sam Bombay.
That's his name.
Yeah, so did he change his surname after the whole Bombay Mumbai thing happened? Or
was in admiration. She was like, please fuck off. Yeah, why he was pretending like he didn't need to take a dump?
Yeah, he pretended for like good 7 minutes.
I felt awkward with the camera on.
So now Rohan is in the washroom. Dude, my washroom is so weird. Like the flush is not a normal flush. You don't just like flick it up or down. You have to press it inside the wall as if it's like some secret.
Yeah, that's like hotel flush or something.
No. Hotel flushes are still convenient, right?
Yeah.
This one is a stick which literally looks like a lever. But then you have to press the stick inside the wall. It goes inside.
This.
Every time someone uses my washroom, I have to do one full onboarding.
Oh, like that. Okay. Quirky, dude. Give some character to the washroom. Dude, you're back! We thought you had gone for at least 20 minutes.
You like the flush, huh?
Yeah, it's very like. Make some game with it. See the flush over?
I'm gonna see after this. Never said those words in my life.
So, welcome to the Yuck podcast episode.
13,
No, this is 14 episode.
14, my bad, yes.
Episode 14.
With the guests.
Today we have two
Yeah,
yeah, go for it.
All right, again.
See how informal this podcast
yeah,
is.
It's
like,
a chill vibe.
Take any
yeah. Give it up for
Kevin Durant and LaMelo.
I know one of those references. LaMelo, I know.
Siddharth Gopinath Rohan Dias, both comedians from the, this is a global scene here.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, yeah, this is global. I'm just from Bombay, so it's
Bombay
not
interstate.
I was born in Bombay, so.
Really?
Yeah. I went to my nani's house just now.
Oh, wow.
You miss it?
Bombay?
Yeah.
You know, it's hot, bro.
And what about your nani's house?
Yeah, it was nice. She gave me a lot of food. I come home at like really late, and there'd be like chapatis and like coke and all like on the dining
wow.
table and all. It was very, I felt very like pampered. And all. One day she woke me up and she was like, I got some guy to give you a massage.
Wow.
Yeah. And I was damn hungover. And this is at 9 a.m. or something. I came over at like 4 a.m. And I was like, massage? What? And so then I was just like hungover and this guy was giving me a massage.
How was it though?
It was a damn good massage, bro.
was it your nana?
Oh,
I got this guy, dude.
No, but he was talking about some stories. He was telling me one gave me a massage, he was telling me some stories about like my grandmother or how she was nice to him.
How high were you, dude?
I was not high, bro, I was hungover.
Oh shit.
Hungover massage is weird. They press you at the wrong spaces.
It was very weird. It was very good. But the moment he pulled my chatties down to give my like butt massage, you know the butt massage area? That was very nice.
And this is a guy your nani has booked for you.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Like, it was like kind of shitty. I'm like, his front massage is kind of shitty. Then he turned me around, but gave talking butt massage, and it was fucking fantastic.
Damn, why was I hanging out with comedians in Bombay? Give me your nani.
After 30 minutes of hangout, so is your butt okay or do
you want some more butt?
I think you're moving to Bangkok, but like actually.
It's a Catholic massage, bro.
Yeah, frontal.
A Catholic massage.
Yeah.
Catholic massage.
Yeah, yeah. You think my nani's gonna have some non-Catholic massage?
I thought all massages are similar category in India.
No.
He'll have like names. So do you know on the crucifixion?
Dude, my nani's keys have a picture. You know Don Bosco?
Yeah.
My nani's keys have a picture of Don Bosco hanging from them. Like in the keychain.
I didn't know Don Bosco merch was still around. fridge magnets.
Don Bosco is like, supreme.
Just take any of this seriously.
What?
All this.
For comedy?
No.
No
religion. But we talk about comedy first.
Religion, huh?
Yeah.
No, but the older I get, the more I'm understanding how, like, the community aspect of it affects your life. That's all. But how, like, it's important to, like, be aware of the community.
Is it because you stayed away from your close community for a while and that made give the realization?
No, I mean more so in this country than when I was abroad or whatever. Abroad, no, it's like only the Jews really care about community like that. But here it's kind of like everyone. Like you got to stick, I mean, you can, like you have to like, it's like nice when there's some Catholic guy doing some shit here. That's really not the case.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You have to be like from, it's like, it like makes you feel good and all. Which I didn't know that was the case. I didn't realize like that, oh, that actually makes me feel good enough.
Oh yeah, I've seen you laugh more at Naveen Richard's show than mine.
Explain yourself. Yeah, I'm not sure what my community actually is, to be honest. Some Tamilian something, but like...
Do you only feel comfortable when in Tamil?
No. So I just feel like some fucker, basically. Not even like part of anything. It's just...
But where do you stand on like your relationship with religion and
religion? God? Dude, I think like I stopped caring when I was some 13 and 14, something like that. I think that puja has happened at like 4 p.m. I might have been a little more religious, but 5 a.m. puja.
Oh,
when you're 13, 14, you're like, dude, this is.
That's when you start hating. Bro.
Yeah. I can't.
Yeah.
Sleep is more important.
Sure.
14. And then your life doesn't change, no? You miss puja also.
I'm not like, chill.
But it's reduced the happiness.
What's up?
We're talking about community, religion, love, you know, happiness.
Okay. Every podcast, one segment is just us complaining, not enough views, not enough views.
Hey, you guys are getting some views, bro. From zero followers, all you zero following to
yeah.
like some thousand you have now. Something.
Thousand, yeah, that's
in that
journey.
That's a journey.
What idea, bro? You need like a mascot or something like that. Somebody in a costume. Somewhere.
Yeah, I think Vijeth, we're designing one for him.
Yeah, dude, you should do it. Yeah.
How difficult is it for you to find clothes that fit well?
Dude, up shirts are cool. Pants, I need to rock the G unit sag from 2005.
Yeah. But getting back into fashion though.
Yeah. People are wearing like baggy shit, but like, I don't know, dude. I mean, it's kind of like, I couldn't find pants then. But then the G-Unit sag went with like dog chains. And that is not coming back, I think.
You were wearing dog chains?
I knew everyone, a lot of people were wearing dog chains and those chain wallets.
Bro,
that's
what? Which era did you...
Dude, were you not influenced by 50 in like the mid-2000s?
I was really small in the mid-2000s.
Wait, how old were you?
I'm 97 born, so...
Oh, damn. Okay.
How old are you?
32.
You were Gen Z, what, Neelakshs? You were Gen Z, no?
What year are you?
2000.
I think you are a Gen after the Z one.
No. There's no... The Gen after the Z is from 2005 and all, dude.
Yeah.
What are they called?
They're called minors. Stay away from
them. What
are you? How tall are you?
6'6".
6'6".
Yeah.
MJ.
Well, 6'6", huh? You can stand once.
No, I can't.
You're a half. In fucking pop-up girls, there used to be this lady who never comes in frame. That
yeah.
Look like.
Yeah.
Sure.
And the mayor used to be like ridiculously short.
That's him.
Yeah. You can dress as the mayor from Powerpuff Girls.
Yeah.
Mascot for Yuck.
That would be best. And then we can give you like one of those arrows and you can shuffle it outside flags.
Hey.
I was like watching this video yesterday about male contraception and why it's not a big thing. Like if you look at it, we only have two options. It's either a condom or a vasectomy. But now there are sort of... There's a pill now, which is still under... Don't try.
Yeah,
it's under experimentation. The confidence with it. That pill essentially asks your balls to stop making this thing. And then there's another pill which changes the head of your sperm to look like a hook, so it never goes in.
What the fuck?
Yeah, they change the shape of the
I'm
sperm.
I'm not
every
taking
single
that
sperm
pill, dude.
Becomes
sperm
a hook.
Yeah.
It's fucked up.
I'm not taking that pill.
What if the one weird hook-shaped sperm still like, the big child will look like something?
Yeah, the child will.
Everybody pass school here, no?
Yeah.
We're talking.
Hey, I just graduated college, you know, dude. Bro, I just graduated college, bro, recently.
Yeah, congrats.
It's 2 weeks ago.
But
bro,
to be fair, it's been a while since we've done some school studying.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
This hook sperm theory was not taught in biology.
It's not peer reviewed, but hey, it's
It's internet proof.
In my gym that I go to now, it's like for sure that our guys were doing some juicing.
Yeah. In college gym, bro, there were some fucking massive guys, dude.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, how are you fuckers even, how have you had the age? They're 19 years old, bro. How have you created your body like that in the 19 years you've had till now?
Yeah. You need a lot of self-discipline to do that, first of all. At 19, if someone has been able to do that, I don't trust that person.
Yeah.
Something happened to them.
And if they're not doing it compared, like some kids at 13, they realize I want to be like into archery and shit and they'll start practicing.
He's like 300 years late, but sure. He has to make up for lost time.
People have stopped assassinating with bow and arrows. It's been a while.
People assassinate with bow and arrow, even back in the day. It's kind
of
a bad
thing.
There's supposed to be some knights or something that's supposed to cover you, something, dude. Poison, I think.
But they would have like poisoned arrows and.
Yeah,
that was a big thing back then.
What?
That was the trend.
Poison arrows.
Yeah.
So you get stabbed, you take it out and still die like after.
Because the poison spreads in your body.
Yeah, and you assassinate someone. Testosterone must go through the roof.
Yeah, I bet it does, dude.
Before dying, he's like, oh, I can finally feel my triceps.
No, I'm the guy shooting the arrow.
Shooting, yeah.
You guys got into fights recently, or whatever.
He's hard as shit. I've never
UFC.
No, no, like fights at like a bar or with someone or.
You've been into fights?
Have I been in fights?
Yeah.
I think I've gotten fighty, but I haven't been in fights.
What's fighty?
No, first of all,
yeah.
That is a sign of low testosterone.
I've made people get fighty, then I'm like, yeah, you don't want to fight. No, no, so stop it.
Is this friends or random strangers?
Sometimes it's friends, mostly
okay.
Random strangers. But in the total number of incidents have been like 5, acting like it's been more than that. It's been like
then another person knows it's a fight, or you're just doing it to yourself.
I think they're doing it to me,
okay.
And I'm trying
okay,
to.
Okay, then.
They are trying to. They're trying to, you know.
But do you know how to fight?
No.
No.
That's why I'm not fighting.
Have you been in any fights?
Not, I got punched one time.
Oh.
Long time ago.
Was it all?
No, I was sitting, so it didn't even matter. What and boom, sucker punch, dude. And then it like the people break it up and all, so it's not like.
Oh, yeah.
Did you pass out?
No, no, my legs, my knees did go a little like.
Oh shit!
Yeah,
you,
a
you made
yeah,
it
yeah,
weak in your
good
knees.
Shot, dude. Good shot.
Why?
But
did
then
you
it was,
you?
Huh?
Why did you punch?
I don't
you?
Know. He's drunk.
But you did anything? What?
No, I don't think that.
Are you enjoying too much to the music and he didn't like it?
No, it was in a coffee day. Yeah, some good tracks, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, it was because of that.
So wait, so you were drunk in the afternoon or what?
Yeah.
Were you drunk as well?
I was fucking sober in my school uniform. I'm glad I got punched that one time.
Why?
Because you're like. Because before that, you go around just thinking, hey, I can't get punched.
Yeah.
I live in like a nice world. And I'm like, oh shit, I live in this world.
One of my friend in the traffic, he had a fight with the police. And he punched him.
The police punched him?
Yes. And then I tried to say, this is wrong. And he just hit me as well. Because I was trying to support him. And he said, you should be smart enough not to do what he did.
You imagine? These are, I have a couple of friends who are in law school, like women who are in law school. How they deal with the cops, no one I've ever seen deal with the cops. They are professional. Oh, thank you so much. They are fucking great, bro. They're like, first the cop will stop them. They have like stuff in the car, no? First cop will stop them. Then they'll be like, this is woman harassment.
This is in India, you mean?
Yeah, this is woman harassment. You're harassing us. You're women, you're harassing us. Then they'll record that.
Yeah.
Then they'll be like, I'm a lawyer, you're harassing us, I put a case on you, shut up, this is this and that and that. They'll say some big lawyer's name and they'll let go, bro. I've seen that dude like 4 times.
No, he got punched because he went to record.
You can't punch a lady, bro.
Yeah, that is
no, but they do this with women cops also.
Women cops are generally not.
But women cops are rare.
Yeah, that's what. Like, if you're a male cop, they're not allowed only, you know?
Yeah, that's what. So they like shut up and all. They're like, what are you talking about? You wanna you're harassing women and all.
Then the
cop took the phone.
Yeah.
It's not that impressive, but it's a helpful situation to have, bro. Some ladies.
Yeah. But like thinking
about
it, like bullying a cop. Yeah,
it's pretty hard, bro. They must have high
testosterone.
How old are you, Vijeth?
I'm like 29. I will touch in September 10th.
You feel old, or you feel the same?
I feel somewhat. No, no, same only.
But you feel more comfortable with yourself in our world.
Fucking brain malfunction.
Yeah. System alert.
What kind of a question is that? Like,
okay,
like,
he's done it before. How was it crossing 30s?
Dude, I think honestly because I'm in like a younger profession and surrounded by fucking 16-year-olds, it's like,
hey,
sorry.
Me and Neelakshs are similar.
No, we're not.
I don't feel that. And I don't have any some marriage pressure or all that, so it's like.
It's chill.
Yeah, same.
It's chill only.
But do like things happen suddenly at 30 where you have like some certain realizations that fuck, I never even knew these things existed.
Dude, only hangovers got worse.
Yeah.
Other than that, it's chill.
Do you exercise though?
Yeah, I do some boxing.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Oh, literally.
Since getting punched at a cafe coffee, I
can't Yeah, I do some boxing.
Are you good with your legs as well? Because you have like too much of...
Too much legs.
Like too much of...
No, I do too much.
Have you always been athletic though?
Kind of. I seem like a little lazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. You seem to chill.
Yeah, you even you seem chill, but I saw some 100 kilo weight.
Yeah, that's because I was a fatty, bro, when I was younger, so I will not be fat anymore. That's why.
Oh, you got bullied?
No, I was just fat. Like, I was just fat.
You're fat, but you didn't get bullied.
I got bullied.
No fucking pinching your tits.
Yeah, they were pinching my tits about that. Bully was that.
Daddy enjoyed.
I was increasing my testosterone.
Pinching testosterone.
Me and one more fatty in 9th grade, we developed this game called Find the Nipple, okay?
Oh.
And so you had to just basically like, you had to like find it, go like
go
straight.
For it.
Oh, okay. Just go for it.
Go for it, go for it.
Oh,
oh did I get it?
No, you're a little not.
What is harder on a fatty, bro? Or it's easier on a fatty or something?
It'd be harder because they're more.
Yeah, that's what. So you know you get wrong. So
yeah, and there are like several other bumps. One.
Yeah,
one
and sometimes the tits go like sideways. Sometimes it goes straight down. And
well, once you figure out what, then you like just shuffle and shit.
Yeah,
I know. I know. It's not like. I think it's variations. I think once you figure out all the game, eyes close and all that.
Oh, okay.
You play variation of a game.
I mean, this sounds like the game got over like 30 seconds. I have to come up with a new game.
Bro, the IIT JEE coaching class and all, we figured this out, bro.
Wow.
Damn, bro.
That's
have
the
guys,
class where you figure out.
How fat were you, bro?
I was quite fat. Not like extensively fat.
100 kilos?
No, no, I was like 85, 90 and all.
Now
I'm
69.
Now I'm 68. I was a little shorter, bro. Now I'm at 69.
Damn.
You used to eat back then, I guess.
Have you ever been a part of bullying someone, like any of you guys?
Apparently, recently I met this girl who's friends with this girl I was seeing in high school, and she told me at some bar, not you bullied me.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Are bullying
her. Oh, damn.
At the show, she came to the Yuck show.
And she was so unhappy with you, and she was just.
Yeah.
Dude, you felt bad, and shit.
No, dude, I was like, I didn't bully you, bro. Bullshit.
Oh, you just denied it.
Yeah.
That was an option, bro.
There was this window for growth. You're like, nah.
In my opinion, that didn't happen.
She's saying I bullied her. So, okay. I mean,
see, bullying is subjective.
That's not bullying, dude, in my opinion.
I think we're getting a biased opinion now, by the way. Maybe
we should have
heard the story also.
We have a guest. She's
this is your life.
She's a royal one.
Was this reality TV show with
Jerry Springer?
Yeah, but Rocky Saman did an Indian version of it.
Yeah.
Where she would get like wives from like a lot of lower middle class households, husband would beat them and shit, so they would get a husband, and the whole talk show is Rocky talking to them, ki aap apni biwi ko marte the ye wo. After 30 minutes she's like, okay, we have a surprise for you. Your wife and his her mother.
Oh, bad.
It was so fun, dude.
House is not the most popular show on TV.
I think it's one of those shows which will get popular in another 2 years if one of the snippets goes viral.
Yeah, looking back. She still does it?
No.
Damn,
I think between 2007 to 2012, when internet was not that big of a thing, reality TV shows really flourished. They tried a lot of weird shit in India.
Yeah.
I was a very snotty boy, bro. My mom put the napkin. You had guys have napkin made.
No.
I did for a bit.
I had for a while.
I would still want that. It's so convenient,
yeah,
bro.
It's
just like, after everything I eat, just a quick wipe. How many times I waste my time looking for a tissue paper?
But
yeah,
just had on the name badge, bro.
But even now, you have to have a t-shirt pocket.
No, just wear name badge.
Just with safety pin.
Yeah, safety pin and napkin.
That's inconvenient. So you just remove it.
Don't remove it. You keep
no,
it on the
long one. A long one. So you can just.
This is some bullshit. I don't think you guys are gonna do this.
Yeah, dude. I don't think this napkin safety pin was actually a good look. Actually.
Not yet.
I think my parents were like.
Like how many times did you have sex wearing that?
Never, but I told all my friends I did once.
Oh.
I told all my friends I was having sex.
With the when you go at an
in some third grade, I told them.
Third grade?
Yeah, I told them all I had sex.
They were like, fuck, man. I was alive.
Third grade, we were having sex, we were just getting fucked in the ass.
Then one man came to me and
he
was like,
the details. I said sex.
If you're having sex,
I didn't talk about my uncle at all.
You think you're having sex? Prove it. What does the vagina look like? And then I said, like, one line.
Oh, wow.
Oh, you knew what vagina is, you know, like the term?
It does not look like a line, Vijeth.
No.
Just to confirm. Let's not spread positive.
Yeah, I was like, one line, and they were all convinced because they also didn't know what it looked like. But yeah.
Yeah,
so very finally, when one of my friends finally saw me, like, he can't ask me about
it. Could have said anything, no? Hey, it was a diamond shape. Square. Square vagina.
But it's more like a line than the other.
Correct. But how did you know?
I think I saw like my cousins or something. And we used to shower together.
Oh man.
Yeah, I don't know the excuse using that sex, but like,
are you a big fan of public transport, like metros and shit?
This metro is chill, but these Bombay trains, you weak person, you're not God. Go on those, bro.
Bro, I've been once.
But there's Bombay metro also now, no?
Yeah, but that's very limited.
Yeah, it's
so
east to west.
And that has no like integrity. You have to use the Bombay trains, the local ones.
Yeah.
And then only you. Become a man.
Become a man.
Yeah.
Have testosterone actually.
Yeah, those are brutal.
Yeah.
Like
they keep calling me weak, bro, because I don't know about
it. Oh, to your face? I just thought you're weak.
Yeah. My parents, dude.
Oh,
they're like, you don't
just
know.
Kind of like,
because they made
like
a good life. They made a good
weak.
Life for themselves, you know. They didn't have that good of a life that I've had, no. So they're like, now you're weak.
Yeah.
we made a good life for you. Now you're weak. So they keep insulting me about how weak I am. And then I'm like...
That's when you start feeling bad and then the testosterone thing.
Yeah.
You should think about like a comeback.
Just might go for a family outing, just punch some guy.
Yeah.
Now who's weak, dad?
Who's weak, dad? We take them to a cafe coffee day.
Yeah. Who knows?
Or last thing which you can do, you can just deny like how you did with that bullying thing.
Yeah,
I'm not weak. Who said?
Yeah, you gotta do something. Can't just be called weak by your parents and not give them some shit.
But what am I supposed to, they're right, dude. I'm weak because they've given me so much privilege and now I've become weak.
Have sex in their bed or something.
Yeah.
Something.
Come
on.
Yeah.
Or just be around when they are having sex and that's not weak.
Exactly.
That is
that's the strongest move ever.
Yeah.
I was talking to my grandma about having sex, bro.
Really?
Is this the same grandma that gives you massage, buys massage?
Yeah.
Same.
And
the chill one.
The chill. The one who understands my parts also.
She was getting concerned that my brother was not having sex.
She was getting concerned.
And then she used to ask me, is he gay or is he gay? No? And I was like, no. But he's not having sex, but it's fine. She's like, yeah, it's fine. You know? I just want to know if I can.
If he's gay.
I want to know so I can like know about him. You know? And I was like, no, he's having sex.
Yeah.
No? And she's like, you having sex. No? And then we got into some deep conversation about like contraceptives and all.
Okay.
So it was a nice, it was a good thing overall.
What are her thoughts on?
She was like, hey, don't get her knocked up, dude. Like,
don't get
a girl knocked up. She got knocked up when she was like 17, 18 with my mom.
Okay. Maybe your grandfather was the
racist.
I think they were married then though. She's
like, you pulling out my man?
Yeah. Yeah. That is, we were sitting in blue toka.
Wow.
She's like, yeah. She was like, yeah.
Catholic woman. She's getting knocked
out at age 17.
Respect.
Yeah.
She's
16,
partying.
60, no, bro, 67, 68.
Yeah.
16. But they were married by then. She
oh,
got married at 16, I think.
Oh, okay.
That time you could do all that.
Nice, dude.
I don't have these conversations with grandma.
Yeah.
Because she's a young grandma also, right?
Okay, that
because
way.
My
yes,
mom is.
Yes, yes.
Of
yes.
course.
My mom had me when I was some 30. She was 35 when I was.
Yeah, I'm hot actually. Dude, I should apologize. Should give her apologies.
She find it funny, bro. She likes it, bro.
She
likes
got
my sex jokes, bro. Yeah, she watches
oh,
me on
nice,
stage.
Nice,
yeah.
That's
nice, dude.
I can't imagine talking about sex.
Yeah.
But my family is very Anglo like that. Especially my mom, not my dad's side. My dad's side is very mangy.
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 Yeah.
Oh, yes.
I don't know.
Mangy.
Yeah, it's a word. We're very mangy, but my mom's side is very like snooty or like very
like
this. Coke.
No, like fruity, like, you know, like put their finger up and like, you know, they're like, English is the language we speak in.
Nice.
Or not going to speak,
oh, yeah.
They're going
nice.
To speak in English. At home, outside we speak in English, at home we speak in English. But they're not like literal, so. My dad's family has more money, but they're like English.
Maggie.
English, they're going to speak in English.
So
I'm writing a movie about my dad, aunt. Who died before I was born. So I'm not.
It's like a documentary.
No.
Funny film?
She was a very interesting character as well. I think she'll be funny, you know. But she was
like
some air hostess, model, actress. She was some big flame.
Mirza?
You're all running for that house, man.
She's Catholic, bro. Catholic.
So you have not met her, but you know enough.
That's before I was born.
Oh.
So I have all her diaries.
Oh shit!
Oh, so you know as much about her as you know about Gandhiji.
Yeah, yeah, but I have like all her stuff. I am talking to people from her life and all. So yeah. They're all like, they're saying like, I take up after her. Which is the weird, they're all like, you remind me of her.
Okay, that's
it's
right.
Very weird also.
Okay.
This is how you transition.
In the end, the flip is, I am the aunt.
Yeah, I need a good setup. You guys know about me, right? Yeah. Just like me.
All right then.
The third last section.
I just want like an outro to be short before this, right? So this was the 14th episode with our comedian friends Rohan Dias and Siddharth Gopinath. Follow them on social media. Rohan is, sorry, Siddharth is not
off the grid.
He's off the grid, so.
You follow him in real life.
No, I can just link his mobile
WhatsApp
number in the description.
Please,
share the podcast comment if you've seen it till here.
अभी और क्या है बोल रहे हैं कितना
हर बार बोलते हैं यार नो
इट्स लाइक